Hello everyone, in this video I will demonstrate how you can integrate your GetResponse account with Shopify. It is a seamless integration, one click, that will level up your marketing game. Stay tuned. We are now in a dashboard and let's now see how we can find Shopify and integrate. To get started, we will click on Tools on the top left and then Integrations and API. And here you will have to scroll and you'll find Shopify right here. Let's just click Details. And here is where you will see the overview and the different types of integrations. We have three: full e-commerce, contact data import, and product data import as well. We will click Connect. You can go through the overview yourself. I will give you a brief explanation once we click Connect here. This is the place now where you will add your Shopify URL. This is the URL that has your store name, .myshopify.com. Let's click now Connect to Shopify. And now you will see this page. This is inside Shopify itself. And you need to allow the integration to happen. So you will need to install Unlisted app. Let's just click here. And we will now be redirected to GetResponse, where you will be able to see the different types of integrations. And now let's go through them. We recommend that you go with Send Full E-commerce Data. This is the way that you will take the most out of this integration, as you can use automation, abandoned carts, confirmation messages, and let's see the other options as well. This will import your products, your contacts as well. While import contacts only, as the name suggests, it will only import your contacts, and you can add them to the autoresponder cycle, but you will not see the purchase history, for example. And then you have import products only. This is self-explanatory as well, and you can see here what will happen and what you can do with it. You will have product boxes that you can add to your emails as well. We suggest and highly recommend that you go with Send Full E-commerce Data, as you will be able to take the most out of it. And then you can configure here how often we should update the data in GetResponse. I recommend as well that you go as soon as data is updated in Shopify. This will make sure that they are both synced in real time, and this is what we want. How to import contacts. This is as well, you will be able to select here where you want them to go. I only have one place, so I'll select here, and you will be able to select more if you have more. More options here as well. You will be able to import contacts who don't have marketing consent. Make sure if you do that, don't send them an email. Otherwise, just import contacts that gave you marketing consent. This other option here would be for you to see the data inside GetResponse as well, not to exactly send them the messages, because if you don't have consent, don't go ahead and send them marketing information. And if you do, make sure to contact our compliance team first, as they will be able to advise you. And next here, this is self-explanatory as well. If you already have some contacts and you know that you have the Shopify ones, just go up with update existing. Otherwise, add and update existing will be a good way as well to start. How to import products. You will select your shop here. This is the one that we just integrated, and you should import existing order history for your Shopify customers. And next, track customers in store. You should keep that on, as it will help you in the future. Let's just go next. And this is where contacts will be imported. One thing that I want to point out is that you don't exceed your GetResponse plan, the limit of contacts that you can have. Make sure that you don't have more contacts in Shopify than your GetResponse account allows. Otherwise, you will be charged a listing extension fee, and nobody wants that. Make sure that you read through it and that you check your Shopify account first, so that nothing that you will not be charged extra for something that you don't want. And for now, we will just skip columns. I only have the check mark here because I only have the email of my customers at the moment for testing purposes. Let's click import. We will now see the notifications on the right. And there you have the explanation. Okay, got it. And now let's go back to the dashboard, and you will see a very cool thing here. That is the widget. It's automatically connected to your store already, and you will be able to see your performance here. You can also go to your store e-commerce tools and you will see that you have the products and revenue here. You can even click and see more about it. Connecting your Shopify store, it's very simple. It's a one-click integration, and you'll be able to level up your marketing efforts, as you'll be able to find everything in one place. You'll need to manage multiple tools. Sending then abandoned cart emails, order confirmations will become very easy for you as well. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you in the next one.